Hi, fellow Delphi nerds. Welcome to How It Works with Holger. Today, a surprise, I'm going to show you how to create an XData web service for charting from scratch, or in other words, from start to finish with all the details. For the first time on the YouTube channel from TMS, you will get a complete XData tutorial from start to finish. The aim is to create a web page that shows charts. And I was a little bit vague here because it's given you the tool set to use any chart component, to use any database. This is really a tutorial from the start. If you already have some knowledge of XData or you have created some projects with XData, this is something you can use to extend your horizon, how you can build XData specific web services that can be used by components to make visualization easier and stuff like that. And maybe you're just interested how I hook up the database. In this case, we're going to use SQLite. So you can check out this example on GitHub and try it out right away without having to install a database service. And best of all, the database is part of the GitHub repository as well. You will get a detailed description how to build the server and all the services from start to finish, including, and I want to show this because XData is universal, it cannot only be used with TMS Web Core. So if in your company you have existing web applications written in vanilla JavaScript or any of the common JavaScript web frameworks, I will show a vanilla JavaScript web page that will access this web service and show a chart on screen. And of course, we will also build a TMS Web Core application for this particular XData server. And best of all, this example will be part of the deployment series that I'm producing right now. So you will also learn how you can deploy the front end, meaning the web application, and the back end, this particular XData service, to a Windows IIS server. The IIS server will be hosted inside of the internet. So if you book a similar server on the internet, you can reproduce this example from start to finish. From my other videos, you might know, I usually show the end result first so you can assess how much this tutorial covers. So we will build a project group. I called it the stock example because inside of the database, I stored a couple of stocks with their value going back to 2019 up to 2024. And the project group will contain two projects. Project number one is the XData service, and project number two is the TMS Web Core application. The vanilla JavaScript application, we'll build that in Visual Studio Code, so it is not part of the Red Studio project, obviously. The stock service, if we run this, you will also get nice folder structure that all the services, or the service, it's only going to be one service, is in its own directory. We will create database connectivity, a nice main form as seen here, and we will also make modifications to the server container that everything is loosely coupled. When the service is running right here, we will start it. It started on localhost here on port 80, and then we can start the web application. Again, it's a very simple web application consisting of one form only. However, there is quite some know-how in this application because we will populate these combo boxes using the XData server. We will basically show only the years that are available, and then we will also only show the symbols that are available. I only imported the Apple, Microsoft, and NVIDIA stock quotes. So let's say I select NVIDIA, all the years, show in chart, and here is the chart for all those years. And this is just the default setting for the charting library I'm using. I'm using Chart.js, again, universally. You can use it on the web with any web framework there is. And you get extensive documentation for that one if you're interested before watching this on chartjs.org. This is the library that we will be using. But it will all be nicely integrated into the project. But as an add-on, we will filter. For example, let's say I want to see 2021 NVIDIA showing chart, and then I only have 2021. We're not going to spend any time customizing the appearance of the axes and all that kind of stuff. We are going to use the default more or less, that Chart.js offers. It's kind of cool that this is the default with the animation in place. It really gives Charge a nice professional appearance from scratch. The key here is, and this is the difference to just a JavaScript or a TMS Web Core solution, this component here is fed by the XData server. So if we look at the network, and let's say I select all and go to Apple, and I look what's happening on the network level, I see that I call my XData server, I send the symbol, the Apple symbol, and I also send the year, which is zero if it is all. That's just the convention I introduced. And if I click on this, I can have a look at the payload that I send, symbol and year. And the response is not only the actual data points. No, this is the description of the chart as Chart.js needs it. So it literally on your TMS or on your web application, it's one line of code to create this chart. The XData server not only gives you the data for the chart, it also provides the appearance of the chart, which is so powerful, you have no idea. In this case, I am only going to create one example of a line chart with a data set consisting of X and Y values. However, I've also built projects in the past where I implemented it using generics. I created types for the Chart.js library that you can literally build an XData charting server. So you have an ability to create all the charts that you need with one single XData server for all the different use cases you have. And if you go back a couple of weeks on the YouTube channel from TMS, you know that we also have a video that shows you how you can integrate web applications into your VCL applications. So you would be able to integrate this into your VCL application that maybe modifies your data, and then you can use this for the visual representation to have the same visual appearance on your web page as you have as part of your desktop application.